No one wants hate crimes to increase. No one wants those with these ugly ideas to feel comfortable acting out here. Back to the shadows, where you belong. That must be the collective clarion call. We need this at home, and the world needs us to be the best of ourselves right now. We're not immune to the insurgency of hate. We never have been. This is not the latest. It's not the first. It's not even the worst. But as always, it demands our best. Will America rise? Thank you for watching. CNN Tonight with Dee Lemon right now.
I hope so, Chris. I hope so. That was very optimistic. You said what we have to do, but will we do it is a question that you asked. I really, really hope so. And it's hard for me to feel that way in this moment after witnessing all of these over and over and over again and just the hate that we're witnessing.
There is so much hate in the world right now. Now, older, wiser people will say it's always been that way. Mm-hmm. What changes is the will to deal with it. Goes back and forth. Muslims were made into monsters after 9/11. That happened with both parties. Went to war in the wrong places, people could argue. Now there has to be an adjustment. The Obama administration cut funding to look at these white extremists also. So that's about what's perceived as a threat. It's time to adjust. This president complicates that because he has cottoned to it.
But that
he has given comfort to these people.
But when you say the Obama administration, yes, maybe factually, but that was because of political pressure from the right. That wasn't because Democrats were telling him to cut funding for that. It was because conservatives were upset.
Be slow
and
on that.
He got political pressure.
Conservatives were upset, but Democrats also were on, you know, pun intended, they were on their own jihad against Muslim extremism, right? And then you had that weird moment where they didn't want to say Islamic extremism anymore. You know, so there was a swing towards being reasonable about it, but that swing never led us back to focusing on the main problem at home. Mm-hmm. We never got that far. Mm-hmm. We've still put so much resources into dealing with what we should. I mean, you know, Islamist extremism is a real problem around the world, and it very well could manifest itself here. We know that all too painfully. So there has to be an adjustment in resources and in perspective. Resources is the easy part. Perspective is the hard part, especially with this president, because he thinks acknowledging this problem is bad for him.
So, listen, I'm not saying that it's never, let's hope it doesn't happen here, what you said. But so far, the facts are, it is a shiny object here.
Right now.
It is, and it has been. 9/11, that was an outlier, right?
Sure.
But it is a shiny object here, and we forget about all the other terror plots and activities that have taken place, and we only look at the ones that have to do with Islam and Muslims. And as you say, I'm going to steal your word, the brown menace. You want to demonize the brown menace.
You did it just today.
Yeah. And if in your closing argument, if we as Americans want to live up to what you said, we have to stop demonizing the brown menace, and we have to get to the reality about what is the actual facts and truth about what constitutes terrorism, or who's responsible for most of the terrorism in this country. And until we do that, never gonna happen. Ain't gonna happen, as they say.
Look, and even if you want to deal with it on the level of, well, I'm just somehow psychologically more comfortable being afraid of a threat that doesn't look like me.
Right.
People need to know. White extremists hate all of us. Because
right.
Either you're in one of the categories, like me and Dee Lemon, or you're sympathetic to those categories right. In their mind. So really, there's only a thin slice that's going to make it. And look, both of us were just on the list of a guy who's exactly like this, who thought it was a good idea to kill a bunch of us. Mm-hmm. You didn't see the president jumping up and down on that. I mean, how sick are we right now? We've got to be better than this. Yeah. And right now, it's not just about us and politics and media and left and right and all that BS. The world needs us at our best right now. Somebody's got to stand up to this and say, this is not who we are. This is not how we'll be. It's not us versus them. It is we. It's got to be us. It's got to be us.
I'm here for it. I know you are. We'll keep working at it. And I'll try to take some of your optimism. I used to be a glass half full kind of guy. Now I'm half empty.
There's no future in division, Don. Only bad stuff happens.
Yep.